Edgar's back. He's all washed up. Took a bath. He's fizzing. He's fizzing. He's feeling good. He just beat a beast. And he must push further. But he needs to be stronger. We know this.
Welcome. What is it, you?
Strength is good.
Very well. Let me
maybe not in Edgar's case. Because he's not going to be very strong. Yeah, that looks good. A little more health, a little
more power. May you.
Oh, Edgar. What shall we do? We'll get rid of. He needs to shake that off. That beast is still troubling him. Look at him. He doesn't know what to do. Well, he does. There's no point in Fimble Famble. No, I guess we don't. Time to get his clothes dirty again. Ugh. I probably should lock on more. So I press forward. Knowing what I know now of this place, I do not relish the thought. Ugh. Ugh. Not the jump attacks, Edgar. Not the jump attacks. Anything but the jump attacks. And those. Apparently. There we go. Ooh. It's a rude gentleman. Wasting all my bullets. We need to be healthy. Armed. And there's still no guarantee of success. But hey, we're Edgar Allan Poe. We don't muck around. We get down to it. Elevator up? No, of course not. Elevators. I don't trust them. Okay. interesting dilemma. How did you go unharmed, Phyllis? That was a trap most foul. Come now. Let us talk like gentlemen. No? So be it. You, sir. Eat, Cain. Meet, Cain. Eat, Cain. These gentlemen over here look very preoccupied. I think we'll just let them go about their business. No reason to bother them. We've got some things to deal with up here. Some very troubling things. Have you seen Annabelle Lee, sir?
Beasts all over the shop.
Oh.
You'll be
okay.
Sooner or later.
Sir? Sir. I just wanted to... No one here has any couth at all. I'll have you know.
What's that smell?
I've seen abominations like you before.
It seems to me it's after everyone's sake.
Oh, I got you. And I missed you. I can shoot as well. Nevermore! Oh no. What have you become, sir? Never! I don't know where you people come from, but where I come from, men of the cloth don't act like that. What is this? Ethereal. Well, he was interesting. Not very friendly. I mean, I know I'm Edgar Allan Poe, but doesn't mean you have to be brutal with me. I'm just a man, for God's sakes. But he got what he deserved. Oh, these gates. Not built. Effort. Now this is my style. I can certainly appreciate good coffin when I see one. And I've seen a few. A Bergenworth spider hides all manner of rituals and keeps our lost master from us. A terrible shame, it makes my head shudder controllably. Try bourbon. Oh, opium. Should settle your nerves. Distinctly, I remember it was in the bleak of December. And each separate dying ember wrought its ghost upon the floor. Eagerly I wished the morrow, vainly I had sought to borrow new places. New things to fear.
Hmm? Oh.
What?
You must be...
Are you?
A hunter. Very sorry. The incense must have masked your scent. Good. Good. I've been waiting for one of your ilk. These hunts have everyone all locked up inside, waiting for
yes.
it to end. It always does, but it won't end nicely. Not this time. The screams of women folk, the stench of blood... The snarls of beasts.
What are you?
None of them's too uncommon now. Yarnum's done for, tell ya. But if you tell them about this here Erden Chapel, they'll be safe here. Spread the word. Tell them to come on over. If you...
Let us refresh. Before we press further into this... place. I'm a writer and the best thing I can do is come up with place. I think we just go ahead and return. There's no reason not to. Can't do much right now, I'm afraid. Honor bright, we will cleanse this place of all evil. Did they extend these loading screens? Left, forward. Left, forward. Left. Ah, lantern, good sir, thank you. Would you mind showing me what? People! You sully! And another one! You are no gentleman. A man walks around the square carrying a lantern. You'd think he was going to help you or lead you somewhere or take you to the tavern. No. He just wants to kill you like everything else in this crazy world. Take me back. Someone take me back. What more can this place do? Ah. Now I know you won't be friendly, of course, but at least I recognize you types. Enjoy my cane. Isn't it delicious? If I can hit you with it, I can. Ah, Pitchfork Pete. We meet again, good sir. Oh, don't hit me with that pitchfork. And Torchbearer Ted. We meet again. I must admit, I don't know the names. I just gave them that because it starts the same letter as whatever I decided they were going to... You know what I'm saying. Do I have to write it out for you? Dogs. We're not fond of dogs when they try to bite our faces off. One dog. One filthy mongrel. Bullets are expensive, even in 1860. 48, or wherever the hell I am now. Thank you. I've got oil. It's not my door. Ah! A man of peace!
You're a beast hunter, aren't you? I knew it. That's precisely how I started out. Oh, beg pardon. You may call me Alfred, protege of Master Ligarius, hunter of
I'm Edgar
beasts.
Alfred. Alfred
so,
Edgar. Edgar.
What say you?
Alfred.
I might differ. But we are hunters,
Alfred Edgar.
Both of us.
Edgar.
Why not cooperate?
Alfred.
Discuss the things we've learned.
Well, I'll cooperate with you, but I'm not much of a talker.
Very good indeed. Take this. Beast
hunting. Oh, thank you, good sir. It's a fine gentleman. Writers don't get a lot of respect where I come from. They don't make a lot of money. I tried to do it as a full-time job, but I had to take extra work as a fart catcher. Dirty work, but someone's got to do it, right? Ooh. I've been eating a lot of opium lately. Probably shouldn't. That's better. Hey! You, sir, are no Annabelle Lee. I've created a bit of a tunnel. Under a coffin. Under a... What does the ladies call it again? The bone box? No, that's... It's not a bone box. A bone box is your mouth. Ah, another wolf. Hello, wolf. Goodbye, wolf. Thought you'd get the drop on old Edgar. You thought wrong, good sir. All this rolling. Entirely too much rolling. We don't roll in the 1800s. But since I have no idea what year it is, I guess I'll just have to adapt. I have to admit, the pop breaking is fun. And those pungent cocktails, they lie. They appear to be cocktails, and I go to drink one. It's not you can't drink it, it's inedible. Apparently you throw it. Who makes a cocktail that you throw? It's utterly ridiculous. You drink a cocktail. They're delicious. Let us strengthen our vigor. There you are, girl.
Welcome home, good
Quit
hunter.
Hiding.
What is it you... Very well, let me stand close.
I wish to get stronger. Only one? Only... Fine. Fine.
Farewell,
yeah, we did get a few more of those... Ooh, we got a new outfit, too. I should try that on. Oh, that's wonderful. Oh, yes. Now, it does come with a top hat, but... As you know, Edgar's not much of a hat man. It is quite lovely. Maybe we'll use it at functions. Not that I get invited to many. We need to explore further in that cathedral. My writer sense is a tingling there. I hear a strange old man's voice in the back of my head saying, Luke. And my name's not even Luke. Too much time passing between these worlds. Haha. I'm long since for thinking that you people are friendly. I've given up on that notion. So I shall shoot you in the face right off. You are no race. More racing. Still don't recognize me. Ooh. I've been eating a lot of opium. I should not do it. I should not be just using opium every time I see it. It's want to, though. I really do. Yes, I'm right here. You see me? Oh, get up. Yeah. Thank goodness. You interrupted our conversation. Come over here. Speak. No? Die. Yes. If you don't speak, you die. Wooden shield. We are not barbarians. No? Fine. We'll speak to these gentlemen again. And you. I really do hate to end your day in such a way, but you did ask for it. And now you're in your eternity box. I didn't want to go that way. I want to go this way. Oh, for the love of Mary Shelley. And I don't know if I know her, but I know her somehow. Again, the two brains, the eyes and the head and all that nonsense. You just stay right there. Oh. No, no need. No need. I know my way. It's fine. I don't need an escort. Moans. Yes, you. Oh, of course. Fine. Okay. Wish to just... Oh. Stand there. I will happily oblige. Oh, he pushed me. Don't push a man. You politely ask him, like this gentleman over here. He is a gentleman. No, he's not. No, he is most definitely not. I thought perhaps we could talk, but no. Leave me no choice. You leave Edgar Allan Poe no choice but to chop you to bits. And to chop you some more. I write poems about you, creature. Sit down. Shut up. Don't have time for that nonsense. Another. Now I do not, and I would like, and I don't have. 'Tis a pity. We must be quick about this. No need to dawdle. No, don't go that way. Don't. I want you. Now I want to heal. Now I want to get said loot. And then I want to get out. Get me out of here! We'll have none of that. I'll get that stuff later. See ya! Oh no! Yes, that's better. Oh. Oh. A motto permeates through the eyes in my head. Greed kills. But sometimes it doesn't. Huh. Oh, Ball and Mace, man. I would love to kill thee, but I haven't the time. You have plenty of time, apparently. But we have pressing matters. There's another large gentleman up there. We met him earlier. We are at an impasse now. But such is the way of things. We won't draw the longbow about it. Ah. We will restock and refill and re-everything. We will re-re. And we will find the doll again.
Welcome. What is it?
I wish to be stronger. I'm not strong enough. Only one. More health.
Farewell, good. May you...
I'm trying. This is no place for 18th century writers. Oh, I forgot. Well, we're gonna wait then. Because I'm not buzzing back and forth and back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. We should be okay. Edgar. He's at a loss for words. He does have a nice new outfit. But the more he sees...
You there! Hunter! Didn't you see the warning? Turn back at once. Old Yharnam, burned and abandoned by men, is now home only to beasts. They are of no harm to those of us. Turn back, for the hunter will face the hunt.
The more he sees, the more he wishes he had syphilis again. Because syphilis ain't got nothing on Yharnam. Ooh. Ooh. A little glitch between worlds. Yes, you can leap very far. I can also die. Should have made my cane stronger, and I didn't, and I regret that decision. Very much. I also, I'll get a few. I should be okay. Let us press forward. Kill many of these disgusting creatures. Edgar. The sun's still out, so that's a good sign, right, buddy?
You are a skilled hunter. Adept.
I'm a more skilled writer, really. Don't push me. You foul beast, stay back. I shall put you in your eternity box. Go now, Fork. Go, go. Go and find your maker. More of them. There's more of them. Come on. Fight me. Fight Edgar Allan Poe. Feel the wrath of his cane. That voice again is telling me, be very afraid.
Which is why I must stop you.
Oh, I am afraid, I am afraid. I am very afraid. I am very afraid. Oh, I'm not so afraid. I'm much less afraid now. That can be tricky. And he would make a rap reference if he knew anything about rap. Fight them back. Push them away. Get out the door, get out the door. Oh no, there's more. Get away! I'm just a writer. I don't belong here. Even though I feel like I belong here. I don't want to belong here. No, don't you hit the wall. Get back! There's more of them! Ow! Creatures from... No! Don't run at me! You have an unfair speed advantage, sir! Stop! Oh. Enough! And there's more! Just never end these things! Never end! There's more. There's more! Can't a man catch a breather in this horrible place? Apparently not. Oh, Edgar. What have you got yourself into now? The red moon hangs low and beasts rule the streets. Are we left? Burn it all. Burn it! That's a damn fine idea. What the? What happened to my leg? Excuse me. The opium. Really does a number sometimes. That will not be effective. This may be. Stay back. Ah. Fine. Fine. I'll fight you in the streets. Despite the fact that you have a lot of friends that I don't want to play with. Go away. Leave Edgar alone. He didn't do anything to you. No! Yes, yes. Go back to your whatever you're doing. Picnic. Puzzle. Nice game of chess. Whatever. Of course. Of course. Of course. More foul beasts. Oh, Bloodfire. Thank you. Mighty kind. kind creature amidst the chaos. This is a terrible, terrible place. Ah! More opium. He's stocking up now. Edgar's going on a bender. Drop down there, Edgar. And get these. You need these. Made it. Man, he's getting good. He's getting good. Don't need that. Don't need that. Need those. Need those. That oil iron is probably not worth it. It's probably not needed. So yes, these cocktails, these lies about being a cocktail. Actually, you throw them, and then all these creatures huddle around it, and then you take advantage of their stupidity by hurling bombs at them. It's quite fun. Oh, and then they run. And they run. Go out there. Go out there and look at that. Isn't it pretty? Near the fire? Oh. Don't fall, Edgar. That's enough of that. I think you've made your point. There's a man behind me, isn't there? Yes, there is. You're almost dead. Get in that box. You're not almost dead. You didn't follow orders. Edgar does not appreciate that. Yes, yes, you're screaming, you're upset. I know, it's a bad situation. We're all in it. You don't have to make a fuss. Get all uppity about it. We're all in this, you know. You're not the only one. Think Edgar wants to be here? More opium! Okay, it's been a little while. You know, just one. Just one. He just had one. Don't judge Edgar. Judge him for being a bit of a creep, but you know, on his literary works and his opiate consumption and all that stuff, you know, it's just part of who he is. Okay. See if we can handle this as quickly as possible. Which he can't, because he hasn't the stamina. Edgar was never known for his excellent stamina. Back, foul beast! Getting a lot of these antidotes. Okay, let us push further, shall we? Enough of the tomfoolery. We'll need that for something. Blood works everything in this world. Going to be a little wasteful. Simply because these ravens don't recognize me, and they will not listen to reason. It's really unfortunate for them. Not for Edgar. Edgar's doing fine. You know, despite the opium. A lot of opium. And the beasts. And the unfriendly townsfolk. But mostly the opium. It was popular back then, you know? I mean, a lot of people smoked opium and did opiates, and heck, you could buy a can of soda with cocaine in it, so try not to be too judgmental. You know? Ouch. Edgar did not appreciate that. He doesn't appreciate you doing that either. Back here. You need to come back here. Not hit me, and not hit me, and not hit me. I said not hit me. No, nobody listens. Famous author. Opiate connoisseur. Nobody listens. Purveyor of fine whiskeys. Hider of dogs. Hiding-er of dogs. Hider-er? Now we wait. Now Edgar waits. He'll tell you a story of a girl named Annabelle Lee. Or how about his colt's tooth? Edgar does have a colt's tooth. If you don't know what a colt's tooth is, it's when an older gentleman like Edgar has younger man's tastes, where he enjoys a good party. He enjoys a good time. Ooh. I didn't take that opportunity, and I should have. I was too busy discussing Edgar's proclivities, and ended up getting stuck in a little bit of a melee situation with a foul creature from hell. From hell. You're not so dangerous when your friend's not around. See? Edgar told you. Ooh. Getting all the goodies. Edgar's gathering up some wealth here. He's got a stock of opium. He's got some of these stones to make his cane more flaccid or less flaccid, depending on which form it's in. See, I guess this would be erect, and that would be flaccid. So that's what we'll refer to it from now on. Erect, flaccid. Erect, flaccid. Erect. Come, wolf. Let us tango. Ah, I see how you work. You want to stay in front of me at all times. You don't ever want me to get near your butt. Which is actually strange. You're being a dog and all. You'd think you'd want me to smell your butt. That's what dogs do. I'm not trying to be rude. I am not the gentleman of the outs. I am a real gentleman. Come now, beast. We won't have any of that. Edgar senses a shortcut. Edgar is going to be right. So, Edgar is becoming more acclimated to this world. He's a little less naive about what's going on. We're not just talking about ghosts and murderers and typical 1800s fare. We're talking downright beasts, creatures, things. There are some more shards down there. I don't think we'll be getting too blood-starved in this episode, but we did cover quite a bit of ground for Edgar. He's gotten quite a lot done, so we'll get it all done in one episode. And then, in the next, which I'm not sure will be today, because I have to do another Dark Souls, or two, Dark Souls 2 or 2. But definitely continuing with Edgar's journey. He doesn't belong here, but he does. It's strange. I can't explain it. It'll come together at some point. Just the simple fact that there's opium here is good enough reason for Edgar to be here, right? Wouldn't you say? I considered making H.P. Lovecraft, but it was too obvious. Because he is such an influence on that, so I went with Poe. Simply because it's horror. Not that that's all he did. I'm not even going to... Is there any loot over here? I know there's enemies. There's one item here. I don't think these guys ever get up. There's guys hidden out here, but I swear you could just loot and go. I think there's anything. And it doesn't. Oh, there they are. They're getting up. But I don't care because I'm just running out of here. We're not going to take the boss on yet. The cane is way too low. Edgar needs to buff up a little bit before he goes on taking a blood-starved beast. And I could die, so better I die a couple times at the beginning of a video instead of ending it on a death. Although ending it on a win is always good. Some bosses I'm fairly confident with Bloodstarve, but he can catch me. Maybe I've hit that comfort zone where you hit those comfort zones in Dark Souls games where you start to go, okay, I know this boss. I know what he's going to do. I know how to react to it. It's just a matter of doing it. But Edgar's certainly getting into the groove here a little bit. Starting to sew his oops, oh no, he's... You're not disappearing. I'm not gonna allow that. Edgar's not gonna allow that, but I did miss that. Oh, we gotta go get this stuff anyway, so just knocking out all these little errands. We've basically cleared this place out except for the easy stuff, so Edgar should be okie dokie. Can I get you to follow me over here so we don't wake the other guy up? Because that would be grand. Okay, now I don't care if he wakes up. Oh, thank you for your sundry, sir. It is a pleasure. Nevermore! Gotta catch up. Get some more catchphrases. Nevermore is gonna get old. It already is old. I've said it 3 times and it's old already. We got plenty of material. We'll come up with something. Don't you worry. So, unfortunately, I'm going... I'll use a mark, I think. I'll be greedy, but I will be... considerate. Because I do want to get that. But we don't need to go back, so we're going to use a bold hunter's mark. Now, there's one more thing that Edgar could get here. Maybe we will just bust that out too real quick. That won't be too hard, and we've got a couple extra marks. And Edgar's going to just run. He's not concerned about killing his way through here again. Just want to grab all the rest of these goodies, because Edgar needs them. They will be useful to him. That's a 1950s voice. That's not a 1800s voice. I have no idea what they sounded like in 1800s, but it wasn't like 50s. Where the hell did that come from, Edgar? I hear footsteps. I know there's bad things going on down here. Kill them. Kill them all. They must die for that we may live in infamy. Don't need antidotes that badly. Don't blow up. I thought that was gonna blow me off. Or blow me down. Edgar's getting out of character because we're near the end. I think I need to study him more. I need to, get more lingo. So I probably won't do another video today because I want to read up some more. I kind of started this on the fly. The idea of doing Poe has been in my head for a while, but actually playing him is a different story. Isn't it, Edgar? Grab that. Grab those. Your first gun gem, I believe. And we're gonna be real greedy. Shoot. Shoot. Thank you. Get the goods. Get out of town. Take care of these guys in here. Where there come numbers count for nothing. Come here, you. Yes, you. You've won the prices. No, that doesn't fit either. Okay, now we're good. Waste another mark. I just want to know this place is clear. Other than the boss. And the shortcuts are all open. So, Edgar is doing well. He's only died once. And it was a careless death. Oh, Edgar and your frivolity. So I think what we'll do is we'll go back and get our affairs in order. And we will begin, when we begin the next episode, Edgar will face another creature from beyond the realm of reality. We must make his cane stronger, faster, more powerful. Yeah, we might as well. Oh, we got a lot of shards now. Might start pumping the gun up. The saw spear is an option as well. Blood gem fortification. Attack, HP, attack, attack. Take 2.1. And I guess that for the little bit of HP recover, right? Oh, we got one for the gun too. A little stronger, not much, but we'll take it. And we got a couple of these blood baubles. You know how much he loves his blood baubles. And since we're back home, we're relaxed. Let's have a little opium. Oh! 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 Love that stuff. Oh, that's so good. Let's get this one more. Oh! Oh. Sit down. Getting dizzy. Okay. When we return, Edgar will level up. He will attempt to kill a beast. In this strange world, filled with strange abominations, he knows what not lays ahead of him. He looks weary. But you know what? We got plenty of opium. Oh. Hey, thank you for watching. Oh.